Good morning, all my Rams. Welcome back to campus. I hope you all are having an amazing first week. My name is Tia. I'm a peer advisor in the Education Abroad office, and I'm going to be doing a takeover for a few hours this morning. So we are going to get into everything Education Abroad, our upcoming virtual fair. We're going to talk about my experiences abroad. We have lots of polls, exciting things, and everything. So stay tuned and let's get started. Yes, welcome. So I do want to talk a little bit more about myself. My name is Nastia Nuanez, but I go by Tia. I am studying fashion design with a minor in agriculture business. I design clothes out of hemp, and my focus of fashion is very agriculture based. I focus on textile production and processing. I was born and raised in Greeley, Colorado. I'm a first generation student, and I would be considered a minority and underrepresented student. So I studied abroad in January 2020 during winter break with the Academic Advancement Center, also known as the AAC. So to all my traveling Rams, if you aspire to study abroad and you have not yet, and you have so many questions and you're excited and you want to see about where you can go, this is a great opportunity to register for our virtual Education Abroad Fair, which is going to be September 7th through the 10th. There's like 45 live sessions. They're like 20 minutes long. You can register for them. And if you have a class during that session, don't worry, you can watch it later. It's going to be available on YouTube. This next picture, I'm going to send a link and you can register there. Welcome back, my adventurous Rams. I hope everybody was able to answer some of those polls and answer some questions. I will be having a lot more with a chance to win some really cool prizes in a short moment. But I do want to make sure everybody was able to swipe up on that link to register for the Education Abroad Fair. And if you haven't registered yet, I do want to talk a little bit more about some of the other sessions we will be having and everything we'll be going over. So we will be talking about Education Abroad 101, financial aid, scholarships. We will also be having sessions based on your college, so the College of Ag, the College of Liberal Arts, the College of Health and Human Sciences. We will also be having sessions based on region. If you are set and solidified on where it is that you would like to study abroad, we will be having sessions on Latin America, Spain, Africa. We will also be having a trending topics session. So we're going to be talking about budgeting, navigating challenges abroad, everything STEM students going abroad. So please, if you haven't studied abroad, it is life-changing, and you can get a lot more information when you register for these 20-minute sessions. So to those of you who don't have a passport yet and are interested in getting one, did you know that you can get your passport right here on campus? I'm gonna put a link and you can swipe up on it. You can make an appointment with a passport acceptance agent right here on campus at Laurel Hall in the Office of International Programs. Okay, so I just have to come out and say thank you so much to everybody who's been engaging with me and answering the polls and questions and listening to me. So it means a lot. When I studied abroad, it changed my life. So I love doing what I do. We're about halfway through my takeover, so I'm going to be answering questions and doing all of that. But bear with me, and we are now going to talk about our next segment. Okay, so some of you, without a doubt, I know, are thinking this. But we are going to talk COVID and studying abroad. So I bet you're wondering, like, why is she trying to make us study abroad? Like, are we even allowed to go abroad? What does that look like? The answer is yes, we are still sending students abroad. And as a matter of fact, we have exchange students currently on campus. So things are a little different, but CSU has a plan, like always. So one of the biggest questions I want to answer regarding COVID is, how is CSU keeping students and communities safe while going abroad during a global pandemic? We have the answer. So this next page, I am going to share two links with you guys. One is a video about going abroad during COVID, and one is another student abroad during COVID. So if you're interested in that, please watch those videos, and I hope that it helps. Okay, so I've attached the link. Swipe up if you want to watch a video about how to prepare for study abroad during COVID. Okay, I've attached the second link of a student. Her name is Randy. She was studying abroad in Denmark during the pandemic. So if you want to hear her story, go check out that link and you can get a little inside perspective of what that looks like. Thank you just so much again. I'm so thankful that I am able to talk to you all about this. I'm gonna give you guys a little intermission breakdown of how the rest of this takeover is gonna go. Okay, so before I do my quizzes where you have a chance to win some prize, I will let you know what questions are for winning the prize, and I'm also gonna show you a picture of the prizes as well. Before I go, I do wanna plug the Education Abroad office. They are at Chalk the Flags right now, and I'm going to upload a picture so you guys can find them and go talk to them and ask more about Education Abroad. Okay, everyone, I hope you all are answering the quizzes and the polls. I am going to do some other quizzes and add some more pictures from my trip in Morocco. So these last quizzes are just for fun and they'll be about me and my trip regarding Morocco. So keep playing and I hope you're having fun. And I will be sure to let you guys know the winners or hit you up about them and where you can pick up your prize. Hi everyone, thank you so much for all of your engagement. I have the winners and I will be contacting you guys individually to let you know where to come pick up your prize. I just want to say thank you so much. I've had so much fun doing this takeover and I hope you all got some really good information. And I just want to say, like, if you think like, oh no, I can't study abroad because I don't have enough money, or I'm not gonna graduate on time, or like all of these doubts in your mind about studying abroad, even things related to COVID, don't allow those things to get in the way of an opportunity that can change your life. I just really want to reiterate that I am an underrepresented student who really fought to study abroad and to do what I did out there, and got so much experience that I thought I would never, ever, ever get to do. So please be open and be open to your resources and the people who want to help you. Know that there are scholarships, know that there is money, and you can always reach out to me. We're in the Education Abroad office, so please come see us, get your passports, start looking at programs within your college, and please, 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 please don't forget to register for the virtual education abroad fair. Well, I'm off to my next adventure, so I hope you all have a great first rest of your week, and yeah, go Rams.